Shall we start? We are live now.
Yes.
Hi. Good morning, everyone. So those are listening us. We are live now. And with the grace of God, we have Pitupan Baruha sir. And he will tell you about him himself. And he is a great speaker. He was at TEDx platform also. He was at Josh Talk platform also. So, sir, you please start.
Sure. Thank you so much. I'm just wondering if we should wait for just 1 or 2 minutes more for people to join, or shall I start?
Yeah, I think we should wait.
Let's wait for another 2 minutes if people are joining in.
People will be joining us on Facebook also.
Okay. Then let's start. What do you say?
I have heard a lot of about you, and I'm ready to learn a lot of things to you. And I want to become a healthy mind person, so that I can think positive, I can be positive, I can smile all the time, and with a fresh mind. That is most important.
One thing is already there, ma'am. You are a person who keeps on smiling most of the time. I have noticed that. So is already checked, and I do not know about the other things, but probably you are mentally strong. I do not know.
I also believe in positive.
right. Very important, actually, especially
but
in
now ready
like
to
corona.
Learn to you.
Oh yeah, I'll share whatever knowledge I do have right now. I'm happy to share with everybody my learnings in the last couple of years.
But I just want to say one thing to you.
Can
you please share your history, whatever you have done, a lot of things you have done in your life, and you have taught to a lot of educators, to the people, and what lot of things you have done now. So you just please share everything about you so that people can know about you.
Yeah, sure. So the format will be this way, that first I'll give an introduction about myself. Actually, yes. You asked me that, you know, you want to give an introduction. I said, no. I have prepared my own introduction. So I'll give that introduction to you all. After that, I'll tell you my story about my own health and wellness,
that's
my physical
important.
And mental health. Yes. Right. I'll share my story. Then I'll talk about the importance of mental health, importance of the mind, basically.
Mind.
And after that, I'll also tell you solutions, how to take care of the mind. And then we can interact also if participants have any questions. All right, so let's start. I will share my screen. I do not know how many people are watching on Facebook. Probably many people are watching on Facebook.
People will
also
join us.
Yeah.
Because it's a very interesting topic, and they have shown their interest also to join us.
Right. So let me see how much interesting I can make with my slides, because I have prepared some slides also.
Great.
All right, everyone.
So here you go, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So you are able to see my screen also, right? Apart from the slides.
Yes, definitely. I am able to see.
Okay, then everybody must be able to see.
Yeah.
Welcome, everyone. First of all, thank you so much, Dr. Shashi, for inviting me, and thank you, EduTalks, for giving me this platform. I always like talking, giving my speeches, and you have invited and given me a platform. And especially during the time like Corona, it is very important that we interact with each other through Zoom, through Facebook Live and all. Yeah. So here is my introduction. Who am I? Okay, my name is Pitupan Baruha, and it is, my name is a little difficult to pronounce because I am from Assam.
Yes, it is.
This is, I know.
I tried people many times, then I called you.
Right. People who do not live in Assam, it's difficult for them because this is a peculiar Assamese name. So usually my friends and my known people, they call me in short Bitu.
Okay.
And so I am a health and wellness coach, as you have already introduced. I do yoga. But I'm not a professionally trained yogi. It is my passion. That's why I do. I haven't learned it professionally. I have learned everything from YouTube. And I'm known for performing some of the toughest yoga poses, which I have learned myself through YouTube. Like, I just got some pictures for you. These are some of my pictures doing some yoga poses. That's me. That's me. That's my daughter, 2 years old daughter. That's me doing varieties of headstand. And I have done a record in 2019, 2 years back. I have made a record in India Book of Records. So what was this record? You know, headstand position. So headstand position is a very difficult pose, you know, Sirsasana, where you balance your whole body on your head. And it's a very difficult position because if you move your leg a little, you may probably fall down. And what I could do was I did abs crunches. You know, abs crunches, it's an exercise of the abs of the stomach. You do these kind of crunches. I have done abs crunches on a headstand position. Not once, not twice, but 100 times. And I made this record. And they have recognized me and given me this record. This is the way you do these abs crunches. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And I have done 100 times. So this is the record that I have made. And my name is there in India Book of Records 2019. So what else am I? I'm a speaker. I have spoken at various platforms, as she mentioned, like a popular platform like Joe's Talk. And apart from that, I've spoken at colleges, I've spoken at schools, and also a lot of online talks like I'm doing right now. So I have done various other talks. And then I'm the founder. I just got a message that the free meeting will end in 10 minutes. Is it okay? Can we continue? I just got a notification here that the free meeting will end in 10 minutes. Just look at that, okay? So I am the founder and host of Mindful Talks. This is a talk show which I have started of my own, and this is on YouTube. I do not have any physical setup. So here I call successful people people who are authors, people who are into health and wellness. Like this is one person I have called who has cycled from North America to South America for 400 days. His name is Dhruv Bogra. Then I have one by name Park, who is a mountaineer. He has climbed Mount Everest at the age of 24. So he's one of the youngest person to climb Mount Everest. So these are the kind of people, they come and share their experiences and their knowledge. Even people from spirituality, people from various other fields, I call them, I talk to them, interview them for half an hour to 45 minutes. Then like he was one of my guests, is Dr. Batra. Probably you must be knowing Dr. Batra. He's a big chain of clinics, Batra Clinics. So I have called him, he's a Padma Shri also. So these are the kind of people that I have called to my shows. And I have tried to pick up their brain within a span of 30 to 40 minutes. I would try to grab all knowledge that they have and share it for free on YouTube so that people can learn from them. Then I'm also the co-founder of an NGO. I do, a lot of charity, but quite amount of charity. I like helping people. So I've started this charitable organization 3 years back, which is called Hope Begins Foundation. Initially, we have started by organizing sports tournaments for the disabled and differently abled people. That was our initial work. Then slowly, we started going to other sectors also. We have started distributing foods. In the time of Corona right now, we are distributing free foods to a lot of people, especially laborers who do not have any money source of income right now because of Corona. We are helping them with food materials and ration. So that's all about me, about my introduction. Now, why am I into health and wellness? Why am I interested in this health and wellness and not in other field? So let me just stop and then let me share my story, why I got into this. You see, when I was a child, I had suffered from two of the, I wouldn't say most difficult, but two mental issues. And even I was not physically strong. I was suffering from depression and OCD. It's called obsessive compulsive disorder. For those of you who do not know OCD, let me explain. OCD is like, you must have known people who like to wash their hands all the time. They feel that there is some dirt in their hands. Or there are people who like to confirm again and again whether they have turned the gas knob or not, whether they have closed the door or not. So there are people who have this OCD. It's a compulsive disorder. You are forced to do that. Even though you know that there is no germ in your hand, you feel like washing your hands all the time. Even if you know that you have closed the door, you still feel like going and confirming it. So these are some common types of OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. My OCD was that I like everything organized and everything symmetric. Symmetric in the sense, if there are pens or something on my table, I always like them to be parallel. I always like to be kept in a symmetric order. If there are chairs and they are just kept here and there, I don't like to see them here and there. I always like to keep them in symmetric position. So that was my obsession. Without doing that, without making them symmetric and keeping in a proper format, I don't feel happy. Apart from that, when I walk on the floor, if there are tiles on the floor, what I would do was I would put my leg exactly at the center of each tile and walk. I don't keep my legs randomly. When I'm going up and down stairs, I always like to jump with both my legs. I know it sounds very odd, but that is what I used to do. I don't want to walk on the stairs. I feel like jumping with both the legs because I feel an obsession that both my legs are equal to me. When I was in sixth standard, this happened. And for somebody else, they may feel that, you know, he's just a childish boy. He's just playing around on the stairs. Nobody thinks that, you know, that something is wrong with me. Even I did not know myself that there was something wrong with me. And at the same time, I also used to feel some kind of sadness from inside. I could not explain this to anybody. What kind of a sadness is that? I used to feel scared of sleeping at night. That was in sixth standard. Till 10th standard, I had to suffer both from OCD and depression. And I'm telling you, see, when I was a child, I did not know that these are called OCD and depression. I just thought that there is something wrong. Later, I came to know. I'll tell you how I came to know about it. Apart from these two mental issues, I was not even physically strong. I was not able to participate in any of the sports events when I was in school. When I used to play on the playground, I would fall down, blackout. I would just fall down because of giddiness. I was so physically weak. My friends who are in my school, they probably definitely would remember that when I used to play on the when there was sports event when I was in school, all the boys from my class would participate in some or the other sports. They would play football, they would play cricket. In the whole class, I would be the only boy who wouldn't participate in any of these sports. With all the girls, I would be the lone boy who would be doing painting, playing musical instruments. I used to do these things because I was not physically strong to play on the ground. There were many occasions when I used to fall down in school. I used to black out and somebody had to call my father and my father would come and they would take me home. This had happened so many times. So I was suffering from OCD and depression. Mentally and physically also, I was not strong. I was not able to participate in any of the sports. And when I was 22 years old, I overheard one of my friends saying that, you know, hey, this person has got OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. I asked him, wait, what is that? He said, it's OCD. This person always jumps from the stairs when he goes down. He does not walk. I felt something is similar to me also. It's about my story also. Then by this time, when I was 22 years old, we had internet. When I was a child, I did not have internet. I did not even know anything. I went to Google and I typed OCD and depression. I got everything about what is OCD, what is depression. I got every details. That is when I realized that, oh my God, I was actually suffering from OCD and depression myself when I was a child. I did not even know the names. Basically, I have fought depression and OCD without even knowing their names. So when I grew up now, I was working in corporates. I did not enjoy my job. I wanted to do something of my own. I thought, what to do? In which field shall I go? I thought, why not in health and wellness? Because I'm somebody who has experienced this myself. मैंने खुद इसको झेल के आया हूँ मैं बचपन से. Then I thought, okay, this is the best thing to do, that I can teach others how to be healthy both mentally and physically. And that's why I'm into health and wellness. So that was my story about my reason to be in the health and wellness industry. Now let's talk about the most important thing, which is the mind. I just like to tell Dr. Shashi or whoever the organizers are, it's written here that remaining meeting time is only 1 minute 30 seconds. So I think it may get disconnected. Just look into it. Can I continue, or I hope it will not get disconnected in between. Shall I go to the next part? Remaining time, 1 minute. Okay, let's see. If it gets disconnected, we can anyways connect again. So we will continue now. I'll share my screen again now for the next part. So I have told you my story. Why am I into health and wellness? Now let's come to the importance of the mind. So I want to tell this, the importance of the mind, in a very different perspective. So I have made a slide of these things. Now, what are these things? You must be wondering, what is the relation of these things with the mind? I'm showing some mobile, a car, a bike, a laptop.
Sir, you continue.
Yeah, hello. Tell me, ma'am. Can I continue? Okay.
Until then. Sir, start.
Okay. All right, so there was a technical glitch, but we are back now. And welcome back, everyone, after this interval. So this was a kind of an interval in between a movie. So we will go to the next part. I have spoken about myself, my introduction, about my story. Now let's come to the main part, which is the importance of the mind. So I'm sharing my screen again. All right, I have spoken about why am I interested in health and wellness. Now let's come to this. Okay. So the importance of the mind. Let's understand how important is the mind. And have you really understood the mind? So I have got some pictures for you. I have made, I have got a picture of mobile phone, car, bike, and a laptop. And you must be wondering, what are these things? How is it related to the mind? You see, these things make our life very comfortable. Your mobile phone, it has made life so sophisticated, so comfortable nowadays. Everything you find on the mobile, right? You call your friend, you do WhatsApp, you do video call. Car, it has made our life so easy. Imagine if you have to walk for 10 kilometers to meet a friend. Now you five people can sit in a car and go and meet your friend in 10 kilometers away within just 15 minutes. A bike, a laptop. Now, what would happen if these things, just a question, imaginary question, okay? What would happen if these things go out of control? If these things go out of control, then what would happen? Just imagine for a second. What if you are dialing somebody and the phone dials somebody else? What if you're trying to WhatsApp somebody and WhatsApp goes to somebody else? It's time to throw the phone away, right? Because the phone has gone out of control. What if the car goes out of control? You want to go to the right side, but the car takes you to the left side. You want to go slow, but the car speeds up. What if the car goes out of control? What if the bike goes out of control? What if the laptop goes out of control? But thankfully, these things are under control. I'll come to, you must be wondering, what am I saying? I'll come to that. These things that make our life easy, they are under our control completely. We can use them the way we want. Let's come to the next part now. So these are also some things that we have got. Your hand, legs, mouth, eyes, just few examples. What if your hand goes out of control? Let's say I want to write something and something else gets written on the board. What if your legs go out of control? You want to go right, your leg takes you to the left. What if the mouth goes out of control? You want to speak something, something else comes out of your mouth. What if the eyes goes out of control? You want to see something, but the eyes shut down. It does not want to see. You want to sleep, but the eyes open up. So these are imaginary questions anyways. They are not practical. But imagine if these things go out of control, your life will become a mess. Thankfully, your car, bike, and your hand in your legs, everything are under our control. But you know what? One of the most important, most searched thing on the internet is how to control the mind. Now, do you realize how important this thing is, how difficult, how big an issue is? All things are under our control around us. Your light, your car, your house, your dog, everybody is under your control. Only this thing is not under your control. These things that make our life sophisticated are level 3. The mind does not directly control. The mind controls the level 2 items. That is, level 1 comes the mind, then comes level 2, which is your hand, your legs. Then your hand and legs control your car, your mobile, your bike. Isn't it? So the level 3 and level 2 are under your control, but the level 1 itself is not under your control. Then whole life will be a mess. Because this is the boss. It controls everything around you. You see, if something goes wrong with your hand, let's say you have a broken bone on your hand. So this issue is limited to only your hand. It will pain and you just take painkillers, you take injections. The problem is limited to the hand only. But if something goes wrong with this, it is not limited to only this. It is limited. It is about your whole life. Your whole life will become a mess if something is wrong with this. And how to control the mind, how to go out of depression, how to be happy. These are some of the most common things searched on the internet. Just imagine how big an issue is. Just because everybody are in the same position does not mean that it's not a big issue. It is a very big issue. Now let's understand, this is very interesting. What exactly is the mind? What is the mind? Have you ever questioned yourself? The most people, when we ask what is the mind, they say, mind is here. Where is the mind if I ask? Mind is here. In a layman's way, we say mind is here, but that is not true. Your brain is here, not the mind. Let me repeat that. Your brain is here, not the mind. Even I show that my mind is here, but it's not true. You see, what is the difference between a mind and a brain? Let me clarify this first. Brain is an organ. Mind is not an organ. You can see the brain, right? You can touch the brain. If you dissect a dead body and take out the brain, you can literally see the brain or touch the brain. Can you see the mind? Can you see somebody else's mind? Then what exactly is this mind if you cannot see it? If you cannot see the mind, if you cannot touch the mind, then how do you control this mind then? If I can see this mic, I can control this mic, right? I can do something about it. If I do not see something, how do I take care of this then? Isn't it a big question? Interesting, right? First of all, brain and mind are different. And mind is something that you cannot see, you cannot touch. Then how do you control that? You see, one way of controlling the mind. Okay, there are a lot of ways. One way of controlling the mind is through mind and body balance. You see, the mind and the body are both connected. Let me also clarify this to you. The mind and the body are connected. If something goes wrong with the body, your mind gets affected. And if something goes wrong with the mind, your body gets affected. Most people don't realize this. So the mind and the body are connected. So one way to take care of the mind is by taking care of your physical body. Or in other words, balancing the mind and the body. If you balance both, then your mind will automatically get into control. Almost most of it will get into control. If you balance your mind and body, that's all. Now, how to balance the body and the mind? That's the next question, right? If I tell you that balance your mind and body, next question is how to do it. One way of doing mind and body balance is yoga. You can balance the mind and the body by doing yoga. Now, I like clarifying things. I would also like to clarify one more thing here today. What exactly is yoga? So I have written it down. What exactly is yoga? Have we actually understood what is yoga? Now, this is something that if you learn this today, your perception about yoga will change. Yoga is not just an exercise. I'm not saying yoga is not an exercise. I'm saying yoga is not just an exercise. It is much more than that. In a very short time, let's understand what exactly is this yoga. Please listen to this carefully. Okay. See, as per Patanjali, yoga has 8 limbs. Yoga is a way of living. Just by twisting and turning your body does not mean yoga. The next slides will explain this to you. You see, as per Patanjali, there are 8 limbs of yoga, and yoga is a way of living. Yoga is not just an exercise. Then you also must be wondering, what is meditation? What is pranayama? If you ask most people, what is the difference between yoga, meditation, and pranayama? Most people do not know. They will say, they are all part of yoga. Or somebody will say, meditation is for this, cool the mind. Yoga is to make the body flexible. That is not completely right. There are 8 limbs of yoga. Listen to this carefully. It's a very short thing, but it will clarify a lot of things. There are 8 limbs of yoga. First is called Yama. Yama means, I'm not trying to explain all these unnecessary things, because if I have to go through every explanation, it will be a too long a speech, okay? So just understand that there is something called yama, niyama. Niyama, by the word you understand, a niyam. There are some niyams to live on this planet. There are some niyams like do not steal, do not harm anybody. These are some niyams that you should follow. The third limb of yoga is that it says that everything is taken care of. You know how to live on this planet, how to be good to somebody, how to maintain cleanliness. You know everything. It is also important to take care of the body, right? If you do not take care of the body, then how will you enjoy this life? So there are some asanas, which if you do, then your body will be balanced. Asanas, right? What do you mean by asana? Posture. And this is called yoga asana. This is the exercise part that we call everybody in general as yoga. Yoga asana means the exercise, physical exercise that we do. Twisting and turning your body. See, just by saying yoga does not mean exercise. I hope this is making sense. Just by saying yoga does not mean exercise. If you tell somebody, hey, I'm doing yoga, you cannot do yoga. Yoga is a way of living. In that, asana, which is one part of yoga, is the physical exercises. Next comes pranayama. Now, you have taken care of the body through yoga asanas. There is a life force inside our body also, right? Which can be controlled through breath work. Deep breathing, kapalbhati. You must be knowing these things. So this is pranayama. See, asana, pranayama are part of yoga. Next comes pratyahara. Don't have to know about it. Dharana. Don't have to know about it, because that will make it too long. Dhyana. The seventh limb of yoga is called dhyana, which is meditation. So you see, exercise, pranayama, and meditation, all three are three different limbs of the eight limbs of yoga. And the fourth one is, and the last one is samadhi. So you see, asana, pranayama, and dhyana are part of yoga. Just by saying that I am doing yoga does not mean that you are doing only exercise. Yoga does not necessarily mean exercise. Yoga asana means exercise. I hope it is making sense. So how to take care of the mind? By living a yogic life. By yogic life, I do not just mean doing some exercises. It is about everything. By doing meditation, by doing pratyahara, by doing pranayama. This is how you take care of the mind. By living a yogic life. Now, some more things now. What else can be done? Yes, ma'am, you want to ask something? Okay, so what else can be done apart from yoga? Yoga is one way to take care of the mind, but there are some other things also. Now, I'm going to give you some few solutions about how to take care of the mind. See, consume right information. Consume right information. See, let's understand what is the mind. I have already explained, but let's go a little more deeper about the mind, okay? You see, mind is a collection of your thoughts. Mind is a collection of your different thoughts. I'm thinking right now when I'm talking to you, right? That is my mind. What else is mind? Mind is a collection of perceptions. We may have different thoughts. I may be having one thought. I may be having a thought, and Dr. Shashi may also have the same thought, and somebody else also may have the same thought, but we will make different meanings out of that thought, which is perception. So my mind and Dr. Shashi's mind will be different, because she's making different meaning of the same thought. I am also making different meaning of the same thought. That is the perception. What else is mind? Mind is a collection of memory. You remember things, right? I remember now how to go to an office or how to go to the market. I remember the road. I remember my name. I remember what happened yesterday. So my mind is a collection of different memories together, right? What else is mind? Mind is imagination. inside my mind, I can imagine what I am going to do next after this event. I'm going to have my dinner. I'm going to talk to somebody. I'm going to watch YouTube. These are some imaginations that I am doing right now. I'm thinking what to do next. That is mind. So you understand that mind is just an information, nothing else. You cannot see the mind here. It's just a collection of information. So if you take care of what information is going inside your mind, don't you think that you are actually controlling your mind? What food goes inside your body takes care of your physical body. What information goes inside your mind takes care of your mind. Simple. Now, when I say information, I have given a picture of somebody watching a laptop, but that does not mean that information is just watching the laptop or Facebook or YouTube. I'm not talking only about digital information. See, information is everything. Please understand. When I'm talking to my friends and they are saying something, I'm interacting with them, that is also an information that is going inside my head. When I'm outside, when I'm walking on the road, the things that I'm seeing, that is also an information. My mind, subconscious mind, is consuming this information all the time. The moment I open my television, I just see corona everywhere. That is also an information. Those information are going inside our head. So what happens if I just hear about corona all the time through news, through people? I get scared, right? I fear. So you see how this information is generating different emotion inside my mind. Let's say I see on the television, let's say I see only funny things, funny videos, people cracking jokes. So what will happen to me? I'll start feeling happy. The information around is controlling how I am feeling. So information is not just on the laptop, information is everything. So be with the right people, talk the right things. It is said that you are the average of the five people who are close to you. So choose the people who talk the right things to you. This is how. By controlling the information that goes inside your mind, you can take care of your mind. That is also one way of taking care of your mental health. To take care of the physical health, you take care of the food. Take care of the mind, you take care of the information. Simple. Next, meditation. You see, I haven't written down meditation only. It's meditation, silence, or mind rest. See, the mind is also kind of a machine. It also needs rest. Sleeping is one thing, but apart from sleeping throughout the day, you should give some rest to the mind. The mind needs rest. See, there are different types of four levels of brain waves. The highest level of brainwave is called beta waves. And there are three more levels which are below beta waves. So when we are busy talking to somebody, and right now my brainwave is a beta wave because I'm thinking and talking to you, right? When I interact with somebody, when I walk on the road, when I'm reading a book, my brain is on beta waves because it is continuously absorbing information. But there are lower levels of waves also. Like when I'm resting, arms and not thinking about anything, my brain waves go down. It's called alpha waves. When I'm about to sleep, let's say I'm just drowsing off, that is when it is called theta waves. It is even slower waves. And when I'm in a deep sleep, it is called delta waves. What I'm trying to say is that your mind is not made to be in beta waves all the time. Your mind is not made to be busy all the time. It needs rest. This is how the mind has been prepared by nature. It needs rest. So spend at least 10 minutes every day in silence or rest the mind. I'm not saying that you should do meditation and sit in a posture and then backbone straight and close your eyes. I'm not saying that. Take out 10 minutes from your day, go inside a room, close your doors and windows, sit down, maybe on a chair or on your bed, relax and just concentrate on your breath. Do not think about any other nonsense. Oh, I have to pay my bill. Oh, I had a fight with my husband or wife 10 minutes back. Do not think about anything else. Just be in the present moment. Feel the silence. That's all you have to do. That is another way of keeping your mind healthy. One more way. Let's see. Physical activities. Okay, now this is something very interesting. Okay, I'll come to that. See, your body needs physical activities. Okay, your body is made to do physical activities. It is said that the mind benefits from silence and the body benefits from movement. Let me repeat this. The mind benefits from silence, but the body benefits from movement. When you move your body more, it benefits, right? And when the brain is, mind is silent, it benefits. But we are doing it completely opposite nowadays. Just think about it. Our mind is busy all the time and body is in rest. Because we are sitting on inside of in our home, we are watching laptop. During the corona time, we are mostly sitting on our chair or on bed and then watching laptop or mobile. Body is on rest all the time. But mind is busy with fear of corona, with arguments, with office work. The mind is busy. It's completely the other way around. But it's supposed to be the mind should be in silence, body should be moving. Not that the mind should be moving and body should be rest. So do physical activities. As I said initially, in between that, you know, the mind and the body are connected. If you keep the body in good health, the mind automatically gets benefited. Next, eat natural food, avoid processed food. You see, food also affects our mind. Now, this is something most people don't understand. They think that food only affects the body. No, that's wrong. Food also affects the mind. Because there are a lot of actually the spiritual things behind it. What kind of food you eat? See, the people who eat a lot of non-veg, chicken, and a lot of heavy things, they will be mostly angry all the time. They'll be mostly furious all the time. I'm not saying it happens immediately. Let's say you have a piece of chicken today, you don't get angry immediately. But on a long run, I'm saying the people who eat a lot of non-veg, their mind gets affected because their body is spending more energy on digesting these food. And people who eat a lot of processed food, you see, processed food is not food, first of all. It is an empty food. You don't get any nutrients. You just get the taste. So processed food are very heavy for the body. When you're putting this junk food inside your body is spending more energy to digest that food. So what did I say? Mind and body are connected. If you're troubling your body, your mind is automatically getting disturbed because of that. The fourth way of taking care of the mind is by having the right food. Another two more ways. Fifth one is the sufficient sunlight that you have to take. You see, sunlight has a very strong energy for humans. Most people know that, you know, when you go to sunlight, you get vitamin D, but it's more than that. It enhances your mood. You see, people who live in very cold places where there is very less sunlight, the depression cases are very, very high. It's a general study. You can go to Google and find it out. People suffer from more depression where in countries they do not get sunlight. So sunlight is connected to your mood also, not just to your body to produce vitamin D. The nature has made sunlight to make you happy, to make you energetic all the time. So take sufficient sunlight. When I say sufficient, we should take, it is said that, you know, to be healthy, we should take minimum of 40 minutes of sunlight every day. 40 minutes. You can read a book. You can do your office work sitting on the balcony and taking sunlight. You can do a lot of things, but take sunlight. Go out in the sun. And the last one. The last one is spend time in the nature. You see, this is the last point, by the way. After that, we'll finish it off. The human body is made to be in the nature. Understand this. The human body is made to be in the nature. If I have to go back to the past and long past, how the evolution has happened. Human beings have been living in jungles, right? People haven't evolved in buildings. They have been living in caves and jungles and all. So the human body has evolved that way that it has seen nature all the time. Only in the last couple of years, probably 100, 200, 300 years, we are mostly living on buildings. We do not have any connection with the sunlight. We do not have any connection with grass or the water or the river, anything. We are mostly inside our home, in front of a laptop. So the body is taking now time to adjust to this kind of a situation because it has not, evolution-wise, it has not seen this. The body is made to be in the nature. For example, if you go barefoot on the grass or on the soil or anything that is nature, you can even climb the tree also or on the roots of the tree. When you connect your foot to the ground, your feet absorbs an energy from the ground. And that is pure science, I'm saying. All right. Nature has made the body in such a way that it absorbs energy from the ground. People have been living barefoot on grounds and all this while. People were not wearing shoes from all the time, right? People, you see the village, people living in rural areas, why they are so healthy? Because they are on the ground most of the time, walking in the field. Farmers, they go barefoot on the ground and walk on the field. But we people living in the cities, we have very less connection with the ground. So spend time in the nature, or at least spend time going barefoot on the grass. If you have grass parks or something nearby, go there and spend some time. That will enhance your mood. That will keep your body in good condition. And that's also one way of keeping a healthy mind. So that's all I wanted to share. I have probably given some points that you can include, you can use in your own.
Your mind, voice like, is not clear.
Right now or from beginning? Hello?
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah. Right now, is it not clear, my voice?
Hello?
Can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me now? Yes, so this was everything that I wanted to share. If you have any questions, you can ask.
There is a little problem. I think I'm unable to hear you, but it was very interesting session. We also, with us, we have Amitava, sir. And okay. We would like to ask a lot of questions to you.
Yeah, yeah, please.
Hi, Vithupan.
Hello, hello, sir. How are you?
Hi, good. Definitely a interesting session, and you know, very relevant because right now it's pandemic going on. Now, my question will deliver, the first question will deliver kind of, you know, definitely related to the pandemic. The students, but because the EduTalk, there are majority of the audience are probably the parents and the teachers and the students. Now, the situation are very different, you know, the students are confined to a room or probably in the home and somewhere. Probably at Mumbai, we are thinking to have some, you know, unlocking from 1st June. But you never know when the third wave will come. So when somebody is going out, it is very easy. You go to mall, you get some kind of refreshment, you go for a movie, you go to park, right? You go to the nature, what you say. A lot of stuff can be done. But the last 1 year is very difficult. The people who are staying continuously at home in front of laptop versus the housewives who are not only doing work at home, also kind of, you know, handling their husband's tantrum at home. Because I'm, of course, one of them. That's why I'm telling, right? How people can get the mental refreshment when they're at home? Very important task to be learned, probably.
Right. No, that's a very good question, actually, and very true that... all solutions. I hope my voice is okay to you. Is it fine?
It's okay. Completely all right. Yes.
Okay. So it's very practical that you have said, you know, the practical, we cannot go out in the nature right now. But at home also, you can do a lot of things. For example, one way how it is affecting my mind is that most of the people are in fear right now because of the news. About the corona. See, I'm not saying that, you know, you should not keep yourself updated about the pandemic. It is very important you keep yourself updated. But all the time, if you're consuming information about corona from everywhere, there is a fear that is getting generated inside you. Even if you get fear also, if your luck is bad, if you're exposed to this virus, you'll get the virus. Even if you're cool and calm also, you may get the virus. Right? It is probabilities there with everybody. But by fearing, by being in fear most of the time, you are actually, it is scientifically proved that you are reducing your immunity already by being in fear. So one suggestion would be, instead of watching the news all the time, watch some comedy channels on TV. I'm saying that use the digital platform itself, but watch some comedy things. That is one thing you can do. Second suggestion would be, humans actually feel a lot of, it affects the brain a lot when you chit chat with people. But this is something wrong, but you can still do it when you gossip. Okay, let me use the term gossip. See, gossip is taken in a negative way. But when we gossip about somebody, after gossiping and while gossiping, it makes us feel happy, isn't it? So why don't you make groups, like, you know, when you have school friends groups, just make them and fix a time that let's come at this time and then we'll meet. No agenda, nothing. Just come on Zoom. And if five friends meet on Zoom. But it's not
happening. Means everybody nowadays is so much busy and they are, you know, when we do like the same. So they say we are right now, we are busy. Just ping us on 10 o'clock. When 10 o'clock we start the Zoom meeting, they all are busy. Nobody came.
That is true. That happens with everybody. Like, we make travel plans and then at the last moment, many people cancel it. Yes. Like, I have my group, school friends group, with whom I chit chat a lot, not every day, but most of the time. So that is one thing you can do. When you see their faces, like we are seeing each other right now, see their faces and talk and chit chat about something in the past, talk about your school days, that will immediately increase your mood and enhance your mood. That is one more thing you can do.
No, Bituban, it's a very, very valid suggestion. The comedy one, definitely, I liked a lot. But the WhatsApp groups, unfortunately, are loaded with the corona and the COVID-19.
Right.
And unfortunately, right. Nowadays, because of the WhatsApp University, everybody has become the Oxford scientist.
Right. So
whatever you put, 10 different views comes, and which exactly what you told, that, you know, that is making people scared.
Hmm.
So I'll tell you one of the very similar instances, because of course when we receive a lot of stuffs and all, it gives a lot of different things. In my childhood WhatsApp group, my school WhatsApp group, when there are a lot of talks are happening by COVID or kind of negative talks, of course, because everybody is scared, like oxygen is not there, that is problem, right? One of the doctors who wrote at night, there are 2 years I have been handling the COVID center, because he's a childhood friend, and he wrote that, you know, what he is maintaining very nicely is washing the hands.
Okay.
One sentence he wrote was, I am surviving just by one, you know, washing the hand properly. And why you guys are so, that was so positive boost for all of us, trust me. And I think so. It's a very, very valid season, unless and until somebody is putting some positive message also.
Right, that's true. So you have to filter this out. Like on the internet, we have all the kind of information, right? Let me give you a perfect example. From the time internet has come, from the time we have easy information on our hand, a group of people who are becoming smarter and a group of people who are becoming more idiotic because of the kind of information they are consuming, right? People have become very smart, right? They have started a business, and people who listen to all motivational talk shows, TED Talks are available. They do not have to go to a physical.
That's why we invited you to.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, right. So these kind of talk shows, right? So by listening to these kind of talk shows and consuming such information, they are becoming smarter day by day. And at the same time, there are another kind of people who are watching only cats dancing, and then, you know, people killing somebody else. So they are becoming more idiotic. What is the difference? The other people also have the same information. It is just that they have filtered out what they want and they're consuming what they want. The same way on WhatsApp groups also, you have to filter out what you do not want and just have to consume the information that you want. That's all.
Perfect.
Probably one of the things I would like to ask you in terms of the students. Because if I see the students also belong to different age categories. The way the early childhood kids can be motivated, the middle-aged have a different motivational aspect altogether. Similarly, the, you know, college students are probably who are doing maybe PhD or all, they have a different level of motivation. Unfortunately, everybody is at home. And everybody is bound to study a lot, because there is, the pressure has not been reduced. Though the exam is not there, but the pressure has not been reduced. At least I can vouch, because I have not reduced pressure at my college.
Okay.
How do you see that, how students can get the motivation on? The reason I am asking, because we are having the same talk with the other kind of, you know, academicians also. See, last year people had a hope that this year things might go slightly smooth and things will be offline or people will start and the students will come coming. So it was theek hai, ek saal hai, chalega. Now when the new academic year is starting, the battery has already been drained out. And again, the entire, you don't know whether it's going to be 3 months, 5 months, 6 months or the entire academic year when the students are going to be online. I have my students who have, like, you know, in my college, I have bachelor's, master's and PG. Now, imagine my PG students who have joined college and moving it, they have not seen the college only. My master's students, those who have joined last year, the year one, they are again probably going to year two and we don't know whether they will be able to come or not. At least Mumbai students can still think of other students. It's very difficult till that time things get okay. Right. The motivational factor is a challenge right now. What will be your tips for the students from different categories, which probably not, I'm not talking about only the school students, but definitely parents also need to think about the mental condition because, you know, they are also at home. The parents themselves are frustrated with their own work. Plus the kid is there. So it's a double triple game altogether, right?
Right.
So what would be your suggestion? Because right now probably mental health is something that is more important than the physical health.
Yes.
Of course, of course. Okay, just before that, I would like to tell you, it says 3 minutes left. Okay, remaining time. Probably we may have to connect again if it gets disconnected. So obviously you said that, you know, when it comes to the lower age group of children, so the responsibility is completely on their parents. What they want you to see, because they will listen, right? Mm-hmm. There are good youth kids channels on YouTube. Probably they can help them by letting them see those channels. And children, actually, we all know that children go by examples, not by what we say to them. So we, the parents, have to become an example. I have a 2-year daughter, but she's too young now. When I do exercise yoga at home, I have seen her copying sometimes. I have put a video on social sites also. Yes, she tried copying. But what if I try to tell her that do yoga? She'll not understand. She's just 2 years old now. She'll not even understand anything, right?
Right.
So children learn by what we do, not what we say. Mm-hmm. So parents have to be role model for them. So if a child, let's say a young, very young child of say 10, 12 years, if he sees his parents or her parents watching only talk shows all the time, or probably learning something or reading a book, don't you think the child will also get interested in reading a book? But if the parents themselves are watching Big Boss and other TV shows, dance shows and all, so the child will also get motivated, because when they are at home, they are mostly with their parents. So they will tend to copy more of their parents. When they are in school, when they are going out, they are among their friends. So chances are more that they will do what their friends are doing. But right now, the situation is different. They will try to do what their parents are doing.
That's a great message. Probably one thing I would like to add here, you know, sometimes parents unfortunately do a mistake. Of course, it's unknowingly they do. Every kid has a different interest area. They start doing it. Somebody start, you know, scribbling, somebody start painting, somebody does different stuff. But unfortunately, what happens now, parents try to put their interest over their kid. Ye karo tum, wo karo tum. They don't allow them to grow as per their own interest.
True.
Let them do, na.
Exactly.
Let them enjoy. Wo karega, achche se karega. You know, sometimes, you know, I see, you know, somebody has started talking slightly in English and probably the other kid is slightly better. And parents are panic. Are uski bachche ko kitna acha? Are, let them grow, na.
Yes.
Let him grow. He might be taking slightly more time. That's okay. Why to give so much pressure? If somebody is doing some painting, jaise wo painting shuru karta hai na, you can't expect everybody to start holding the pencil or probably start coloring at the right time, right? Kisi ko thoda time lagta hai karne mein.